connection with the steel for or the automotive industry course was really about trying to talk about the future of the industry, the automotive industry, and their needs in terms of lightweighting for fuel efficiency and for, you know, environmental impact, and how steel, which is considered to be an old heavy material, can actually be engineered to address those issues. The initial course was to do with the obvious future of the automotive industry. It's a really big challenge for India because the sheer number of people involved in India in terms of transport, etc. We need to find solutions which are not only Western solutions, but ones which are catered for the Indian market. So lightweighting, recycling, impact on the environment, etc. are very, very important. And so what we've also been talking to is a number of companies such as Mahindra Mahindra, Tata Motors, etc., about how we take these concepts forward into future vehicles and their design. And so the students that came from all over India to the course were really involved in how do we design vehicles for more like 2030 and beyond rather than here and now. So with any research project in the world these days, you have to collaborate. And so what I've really enjoyed with IIT Madras is working with Professor Sarma and Professor B.S. Murthy, who's now at Hyderabad, but he still has a strong connection with Madras as well. So the whole point there is, you know, we're creating, in the case of Professor Sarma, he's creating new models, because Professor Murthy is creating new materials. And really the future is trying to combine new materials and models of how those materials are developed into a package. Because many engineers now want to have a model of materials. And so they can't design new cars or design new buildings or design new planes, etc., without the models of the material behavior. And so the collaboration we have there is multidisciplinary, which again is a very strong thing, aspect of IIT Madras, and also my own university, Deakin University. So we've been able to find a collaboration which is not just about designing a new material, but it's about how we use that material, how it performs, etc. And so in that situation, you need to understand a whole range of aspects. And again, with IIT Madras, with a range of professors there, we've been able to do that. So I've also dealt with many universities around the world. And I have to say, without any question, that the international office at IIT Madras is the best office I've dealt with. And I can say it hand on heart because they take care of the arrangements of accommodation, but also they look after the students, the staff, etc., and they get personally involved. We just don't get treated like a number or someone in a queue. We get treated like my staff have come across. I brought many times up to 10 staff across the collaboration, and we get the special treatment. And so I can say without any doubt that the IIT Madras team is a fantastic team to deal with, not only for the actual personal aspect, but also for the development of contracts and procedures, etc. They always try and find solutions rather than try and find barriers, which is a great thing to deal with. So coming to the campus is a wonderful experience. For those who are new to India, you go and arrive in Chennai and there's people and cars and everything everywhere, which is fantastic as well. And then you go to the IIT campus and it's wonderful green campus. Lots of trees, you can see deer, monkeys, which are in other animals as well. And then the accommodation is also, I stayed quite a number of times at the Bose Einstein special guest house, and it was a very relaxing environment to stay at, and it's very close to the department where I was working as well. And also we held meetings in the in that facility as well over lunch and dinner. So, and there's Wi-Fi, there's all the usual things you expect. My experience with coming to India is very interesting. For many years, I did not travel to India. I did my research around the world in all countries. And then I came to India and I fell in love with India. The reason for that is it is so different. Sometimes when you travel around the world, and my colleagues will maybe criticize me, but you could be, if you go to North America, if you go to Europe, etc., it's different, but it's the same. If you go to India, to me, it's so different. It's confronting in many ways, but it's also pleasurable in so many other ways as well. I have now been to India more than 70 times in the last 15 years. And the reason for that is that there is a passion there. There is a passion and a need. And you feel that if you do research in India, not only will it actually benefit because the people there are obviously the highest quality, but also you can see immediately that your research, if it's successful and translates, will have an impact on the average person. And so I feel humbled but fulfilled at the same time with my research that I do in India, because I also do it with the best people in the world.